Hi Cancer, this is Jess with your June 16th, 2021 General Weekly Read. I hope you guys are having an enjoyable day so far. So Cancer, boredom, change may be a problem right now. Letting go of situations and dealing with having to let go also could be a challenge for some of you. There is some good news for some of you. There's going to be some type of, it could be a reconciliation, but for others of you, those that you have been distant or separated from, could be a reunion now coming back together. I see parties and gatherings and some fun times in the home life with people that you probably haven't seen for quite some time. They're not there to stay, of course. They're going to leave. And I do see you guys having a good time in the meantime. This is a time that some of you may meet some very important people in your neighborhood, in your area. You can definitely catch someone's eye or vice versa right now. You guys are in your head quite a bit, but it's a good in your head because you're getting down to the source of the problem. You're taking some time, quiet time to yourself to evaluate where you are and where you need to be heading. And that's really good. You have love on your heart, and I do feel like you're very patient. You're very wanting of someone specific. Those of you who are employed, I see promotions, new hires, and you may be asked to help new hires in some kind of way. I see you being able to take on a role at the workplace that will bring you more money and give you a higher and more substantial title. You have the ability to do that. So if you've been thinking about it, congratulations for any of you who has received the promotion. Let me know in the comment section below if you like to. But now would be a good time at least to start initiating the steps of how do I go about submitting for a promotion, or, you know, looking at your finances and seeing where can you make more money. Those of you who are unemployed, what is this? This is some of you needing to take a break or deciding to take a bit of a break. You may have been looking for work for quite a long time. Some of you may have to go the testing route where you have to be tested and evaluated, that sort of thing. I see you kind of taking a break. I'm tired of looking for work. You may feel like you're not getting anything based upon your salary requirements. And some of you may be making some adjustments to your requirements soon so that you can get a job. Now, those of you who are self-employed, you have to make some changes with this business. You have to. There's some sacrifices, some changes, and probably a partnership, a business partnership may not be working so well simply because someone's lazy and they're dead weight. So it's like, I need to do it on my own anyway. Some of you may be nursing someone back to health, having to help someone, being there for someone. So you may not be able to put enough attention into your business. This week will show very challenging because something is coming out, whether you like it or not. And I'm not going to say, let's see if all hell is going to break loose. It's about to be a showdown. It is about to be a showdown with you and someone. This relationship is very toxic. A lot of things are going to be coming out, accusations, some truths coming out. You won't see it coming. You won't know how to deal with it. It may give you sleepless nights, nightmares. It's someone that triggers you or something that you're scared to come out or something that you're scared to deal with. You have to deal with all of it. And it's like you may have thought that you were on a good path with a particular person. No, the drama, the trauma, the toxicity, it's all still there. And it's all kind of coming out this week. And it's better that it comes out. You don't trust this person. They don't trust you. You have different styles of handling drama. You're going to be okay. You're going to be okay. Some of you may rely on, I get a feminine energy, a fire sign energy. Leo, Sagittarius, Aries doesn't have to be, but you may rely on someone and they're going to be able to help you through something. This is just a woman that is very proactive. So whoever that could be in your life, others of you will take on this proactive energy. And you won't dwell in it. You're going to rise above it and let that person stew in their problems. The only issue will be that some things are going to come out that you probably have been scared to deal with. That's the biggest issue I'm seeing happening this week. But once it's behind you, it's like the best thing that could have happened, because you almost like turn into a different person. You get your confidence back, your zest, your zeal for you, you yourself. So it's actually a blessing in disguise. I want to say this is a blessing in disguise. All hell breaking loose is going to be a blessing for you. Home life, like I already mentioned, looks really good. Some of you, have you had a one night stand? I see a one night stand. I see having a good time with someone and being sad to see them leave only for somebody else to come. Cancers, are you guys? I don't know. That's just what I'm saying. Some of you are having a lot of fun at home, whether it be with strangers or people that you are familiar with. But either way, you're having a lot of fun. And for some of you, this is looking like a revolving door. I'm just saying, you are single. Do your thing. Hopefully you're single. Love, single Cancers, talking about you. Yeah, the ones that's having all this fun. And I'm telling you, this fun, this all may, this thing may get very messy. Very messy. So be careful. If you're creeping, you might not want to do it at your house. It could get very messy. It seems like for some of you, you may not be able to hide. Somebody may just blow your spot and just let you know. And just basically tell everything. But I feel like they're telling it to as many people that could listen. That's the issue. Okay, love. Ladies, Cancer singles, you know, you have something going on here. You do. You do. There's somebody coming in who loves the way you love. They love the way that you love them, or the way that you are capable of loving. This person is very busy. Single Cancer ladies, I'm talking to you. This person is extremely busy. They're taking a chance anyway. This could be the a type of person that says, I really don't get in committed relationships. I don't even have time to date. It's true. They don't. They are someone who is a workhorse. This is not even somebody that's just money hungry. No, they are a workhorse. Some people are on this earth just to work. I've come to realize that about some people on this earth. They are just here to work. And guess what? He's serious about you. They want you. There's a mutual connection here that you both can't deny. And I do feel like if you're trying to get something out of this person, because they're very generous and it's going to be a benefit to you, an actual blessing, you'll look back and say, I can't believe this happened to me. You could be meeting someone who's very financially stable, who's a workhorse, who's a simple person. They're simple. They work really hard. They know their worth, and they're very generous, okay? And it just allows for you to be all that you can be, because all they want from you is just what they don't necessarily get, and that's love, devotion, nurturing. You know the kind from back in the days when you cooked, cleaned, rubbed feet, and gave massages, and all those things, was very attentive. That's what he's looking for. And, you know, you seem to be very natural with that, and therefore he will be very, very abundant and very generous to you. So you will feel like you're being spoiled. So enjoy it, Cancer single ladies. Let me know in the comment section below if you have hit the lotto like that. You just may have an ex being messy. But outside of that, yeah. And this man may have an issue. This could even be this man who's a little bit, I don't know, bipolar, have some mental issues. But if your aim is to get money from him, then I guess, you know, jackpot. Cancer single men. You have to come to terms with a divorce, a separation, an end to a relationship. You've stalked enough. You've watched enough. You've walked away from this situation many times, only to find yourself still at the same place. Now, you may be the person this week going off, having a fit, pissed, needing to get some things out. And you guys, don't be surprised if you see a Cancer man going off. Telling all kind of stuff, because I get that. Just you're ready to face whatever this is, in any way that it comes. And you'll be as messy as you need to be, but you need to get it out. So that's how some of you are feeling. This marriage, if it's a divorce, has probably gotten pretty messy, and it's bittersweet. I don't see it's the only sweetness, I think, is eventually after you get on the other side of the reality of losing the situation is when you will finally hit your sweet spot. But it's a process for you cancer single men. The one that I'm picking up for, it's not funny at all. This is something very serious. You guys are really in your feelings about the situation. It doesn't get any easier for now, at least. I even see through your birthday time it being hitting you really hard, because it may be something very sentimental around that time that kind of makes it real, if that makes sense. So you're having to deal with the reality of losing someone who you really don't want or never wanted to lose. And that's what I see where you guys are at when it comes to this relationship. So it may be very difficult for you to put yourself out there for anyone new, no matter how awesome they may be, because you're going through a healing, is what it looks like to me. Couples. Cancer, and this can go vice versa. Looks like you guys are breaking up or going to be on a break. And it seems like you just came off of a break, maybe heading back to another break. If you're going back and forth like this with someone, maybe it's not meant to be with them. It's a lot of karma, and it's a lot of toxicity here. No, I'm sorry. It's not karma. It's just toxic. You don't have to be in this relationship with this person. There's nothing to learn here. Some of you are just wasting your time with someone who has a lot of resentment toward you. You're trying to get away from the person, but you might not be able to, because they're helping you in some kind of way financially. Like, they help you, so it's hard to get out of it. You kind of have to deal with the situation. It's almost like you guys can't wait any longer. It's all coming to a head now. It's all happening now. Some of you, your person feel like you're using them for their money. You don't love them. They may not even love you. I'm keeping it 100% honest. They may not even love you, Cancer, but they're still responsible for you in some kind of way. They still have to support you in some kind of way, is what it looks like. And they may have to continue to do that for a month or two, something like that, and until it's like, okay, we're dealing with this now. You know, that sort of thing. And you may have been able to drag this out for some time, drag the situation out. That seems to be very problematic, but it all seems to stop this week or by next week. Things are coming to a head, okay? So the biggest issue I'm seeing here is somebody is trying to convince you that they can be trusted, but I would be careful, especially if you guys had some issues in the past and they feel like you've done them wrong. Be careful with someone, because I just keep getting a messy situation, Cancer. I am. I'm getting a really messy situation, and it can get messy. As messy as you could think, it can get that messy. And they're trying to make you comfortable. So if, listen to your intuition. If your intuition is telling you, your intuition may be a bit off with a business partnership, but if your intuition is telling you don't trust it or watch out, that sort of thing, be careful. I think you're getting ready to realize who you're dealing with. So if you didn't know before, you're about to find out. And if you ever doubted them, well, this time around, you're going to really believe the truth about this person. So that's what I have for you guys. If you would like more details on this couple love reading, you can find the extended love reading down in the description box below, along with all the details that we go over. You can also find the Cancer 2021 yearly reading for the rest of this year, or you can also find the link to my website down below as well. Otherwise, if you are new to this channel, welcome and subscribe, because I will be back very soon with another one. Take care, Cancer, and be